All right, welcome back. It is 8:20, and it's an exciting week. I have my binoculars ready, no joke. We're joined by our very own Casey NASA lady, Danielle Jones, to talk about this huge comet that's going to fly by Earth later this week.
It's going to be really exciting to see, so thanks so much for being with us today.
Of course.
Okay, so for those that do not know, first of all, just what is a comet?
Sure. A comet is basically just a big ball of ice, like kind of how you see black ice outside. It looks exactly like that. And the reason we can see it is whenever it passes through the sun, when it passes the sun, a lot of that ice melts off and causes that big tail that you see. Mm. So you can kind of see in this picture, this one happens to be green. Heat comes in a spectrum of colors. So, you know, if you look at a fire, the base of the fire is different than the tops of the flames.
Oh, yeah.
So anything that's on the cooler end of the spectrum, like green, blue, purple, is very hot. You can imagine it's traveling 20,000 something miles per second, so it's pretty fast. It's been traveling the universe now for decades, many 50,000 years or more.
It's so cool, and so that's why it's green, because it's burning so hot.
Yes.
You know, it's going by the sun.
Right, and that's another way that we can kind of tell the composition of what it is and how fast it's going, because we know that heat directly translates to speed.
So I heard if you have a telescope or binoculars, you look towards like the North Star in the next few mornings, you might see it.
So today was the optimal viewing, but it's still going to be visible probably tomorrow and the next day. My biggest advice is to download an app, like a sky mapping app. They use GPS technology. You point it to the sky and it will use arrows to show you exactly where to look. You can look at planets, stars that way. Anytime there's a comet or asteroid or something coming, they put that in there. Google's got a great one. Sky Maps got a great one. That's the best way. Binoculars, great. I say get out of the city if you can. Further, if you could go west or north, St. Joe would be optimal.
Okay.
Anywhere you can get out of the light pollution and pollution in the sky and all of that's
That's going to be the best bet.
And then
what's the best time to see it?
Dawn is kind of our time range, because I mean it's going very quickly, but it's 26 million miles away. So
amazing.
So it's going to be slower in our perspective. But there's also live streams. They did one this morning. They recorded it and posted on YouTube.
Okay.
So you can see it. It's not the same, I know, but if you can't get out of the city or you don't want to be out in the cold, then do it. But it's once in a lifetime opportunity.
Yeah,
and it's not going to, it will not be back for at least minimum 10,000 years.
That's so cool. And is that
10,000 years?
Did I read, Danielle? I don't know if I'm confusing this with another, but that like the last time it went by was like thousands or millions of years ago.
Stone Age. Yeah. And so, I mean, if you really think about it, how terrifying that would be, because, you know, their basis of science was fire.
Right.
You know, maybe a wheel. How terrifying. I mean, you know, there's been whole civilizations and religions and cults based on comets and asteroids.
So this same comet flew over the Earth during the Stone Age.
Yep.
And now it's coming back this week.
And now it's coming back.
That is really cool.
Yeah.
That's so amazing.
I know. I mean, and there's thousands and thousands and thousands of comets that fly by that we can't see because they don't get close enough to the sun to burn up to make the tail.
Right.
But, and we don't really know a lot about comets because we can't get near them because they get contaminated by the sun. So we kind of just have to study them from afar. And watch them and just be mystified by it.
All right. Danielle, thanks so much for being with us today. This is great information.
Casey NASA lady, check her out online. Kathy?